I'm here with Jeff Baumgartner, and we are in the historic Union Station in downtown Denver, Colorado, and we're going to talk about cable.
Everyone's favorite topic.
Right, nothing to do with the location, but we wanted to touch base with you. You're based in Denver, and kind of talk to you about the key strategies that cable operators are bringing to the table right now. What's top of mind for them?
Things that come to mind is like what they're going to do with next generation video, what they're going to do to keep the broadband services growth stoked, and then also they need to find other growth drivers,
right?
You know, other businesses, lines of business to kind of keep the revenue, you know, on the upshot.
You had to guess of how much cord cutters is making these people keeping these operators up at night. How big of a factor is that?
You know, they are starting to, you know, contribute to the erosion,
sure,
of the pay TV base, but you know they're getting hit on a number of different fronts.
Sure.
One is, you know, competition like that. You know, people who are priced out of the market, so that's causing the cable operators to experiment and adjust, you know, their different video packages, and you know, have to be a lot more try to be a little more innovative.
Sure.
Not just with the, you know, the base product, but also products and packages that can address, you know,
right,
kind of the full spectrum, you know, of customers, from cord cutters to cord nevers to, you know, making sure that the high end, the people on the high end tiers and the big packages are also
right,
kept happy and, you know, stay with the company.
Cord nevers, that's a new one.
Yep.
And then in terms of, if you had to take the pulse of how the content game is going for these service providers, you know, we've seen some kind of big flops in the last couple of years. Verizon, you know, went and tried to go into the content game. That was, didn't really work out for them. Is that something that they're trying to do still in terms of generating new revenue streams, doing original content coming out of the service providers and operators themselves?
Yeah, I think, yeah, you're seeing some of that. I think, you know, Charter is one example. They have a partnership with a programmer to focus on, some original programming. I think everyone is very wary of what, you know, Netflix is doing, what Amazon is doing, what Hulu is doing. I mean, they're all pouring a lot of resources into original programming, and, you know, some are hits, some are misses, but, you know, they're coming up with series and TV shows that at least make their service unique. And, you know, I think, you know, the pay TV operators, the traditional guys, are going to have to maybe spend a little more time kind of exploring, you know, that part of the business.
Yeah.
And maybe, you know, spend a little bit more on partnerships and that develop content that might be unique to them.
Sure.
Because other than pricing and packaging, you know, it's and the interface and the devices that you support,
yeah,
it becomes a little more challenging for them to really differentiate in the market.
Sure. You know, speaking of OTTs,
mm-hmm,
Disney's going to be launching their own streaming service,
mm-hmm,
and I know I'm going to be paying $15 a month before you can say Frozen 2, because I have a 5-year-old daughter.
So they have one customer already. Okay.
Just one.
They'll be happy. All right.
That being said, what are the cable companies doing now to differentiate, as you were talking about, from the OTTs in a strategic way?
We've kind of seen a shift in the strategic thinking when it comes to over the top. I think initially a lot of them viewed them rightly so as competition, but at the same time, I think there is also a realization that consumers, you're not going to prevent them from going to Netflix. You're not going to prevent them from going to Amazon Prime Video. So, you know, they've kind of decided, well, hey, we're going to be the aggregator,
right,
of aggregators, and instead of shielding.
Right.
Ourselves from what's going on in the over-the-top game, you're starting to see the MVPDs really try to embrace it and integrate it so that the consumer stays on their platform, you know, whether they're watching their, you know, a VOD service from Comcast or
right,
watching something from Netflix or some other over-the-top source. But they're also being very careful. It's not like they're using their set-top boxes to be like the Wild Wild West, like a Roku device that has
right,
5,000
right,
apps and channels.
They're
being very,
very selective.
Very selective.
Yeah,
and I
sure,
think part of that is, you know, not just technical integration, but, you know, I think there's a big business focus. You know,
sure,
they're not going to do a deal where they're just going to say, yeah, come on our box,
no,
for free. There's going to be a business arrangement.
Traffic. Yeah.
Yeah,
I mean,
and they want it integrated.
Yeah.
They want it integrated. They don't want, so yeah, here's my service, and there's another silo that takes
right,
you to Netflix or another,
sure,
another service. Yeah.
So just to wrap things up, what mobile and wireless strategies are forming in cable right now?
Yeah, it kind of depends on the cable operator, but I think from a general standpoint, all the cable operators are very focused on in-home Wi-Fi, because it's not just about, you know, the connection into the home. I mean, when you think about the devices you connect, I mean, how many devices do you connect with a hardwire? Like, probably nothing, right? So they want to take control of, like, the whole home Wi-Fi experience with, and have control of that environment and have visibility, you know, if things go wrong. But outside of that, you're also seeing some of the larger ones, like Comcast, Charter, Altice, doing these MVNO deals where they have, like, a mobile service that leans on, you know, their partner's mobile network. But then we're starting to see them also look at this new CBRS spectrum band. It's kind of a shared band, and, you know, they can use that to kind of offload some of those costs and kind of have this big combination mobile wireless product where they're using, you know, the in-home Wi-Fi, they're using the CBR spectrum band, which uses LTE, and then they're using the MVNO, and, you know, trying to create, you know, their own, you know, mobile service, and not really to sell it individually, you know, but also but to make it part of the package.
They want you to use everything on their platforms.
They
want to get you, you know, a mobile, wireless, cable, the whole deal.
Smart home.
Yeah.
Home security.
Yeah.
You know, if they, you know, could cook your food, they would do that too.
Wow.
Maybe that's, you know, a future thing.
Exciting,
but, you
know. Maybe a little bit easier for consumers, a little bit scary, but that's the future we're living in. Mm-hmm. Jeff, I want to thank you very much.
Sure thing. Thank you, Dan.
Excellent. Thank you so much. And we'll be seeing, we'll be talking more about some of these cable topics. We got a couple of events actually coming up in Denver. You want to just talk about that really quickly?
Well, let's see. We have the NFV and SDN
event.
So I'll be there to pitch in and kind of see what the cable angles are. And then I think here coming up in Atlanta in October, we've got the SCT Cable Tech Expo. It's the big
Cable show.
Domestic cable technology show. So we'll be there with bells on, of course.
Awesome. All right, Jeff. We'll see you in a couple months.
All right.
Thanks,
buddy. Sounds good. Thanks.